Although rechargeable batteries in smartphones, cars and tablets can be charged again and again, they don't last forever. Old batteries often wind up in landfills or incinerators, potentially harming the environment, and valuable materials remain locked inside. Now, a team of researchers is turning to naturally occurring fungi to drive an environmentally friendly recycling process to extract cobalt and lithium from tons of waste batteries. Because of the huge growth in smartphones and all the other products with rechargeable batteries, the demand for lithium is rising rapidly, and it is not sustainable to keep mining new lithium resources. Although a global problem, the US leads the way as the largest generator of electronic waste. It is unclear how many electronic products are recycled. Most likely, many head to a landfill to slowly break down in the environment, or go to an incinerator to be burned, generating potentially toxic air emissions. While other methods exist to separate lithium, cobalt, and other metals, they require high temperatures and harsh chemicals. The research team is developing an environmentally safe way to do this with organisms found in nature, fungi in this case, and putting them in an environment where they can do their work.
We became interested in this project because everybody walks around with one of these in their pocket now. Mobile phones, laptops, all run on rechargeable batteries, and it's expected that electric vehicles will likely also start using the same type of battery technology, which is a lithium-ion battery. And sort of the active ingredient in the rechargeable batteries that we all use is lithium cobalt oxide. So the two key elements involved in these batteries are lithium and cobalt. Lithium currently is in pretty plentiful supply, but a lot of the projections say that as the worldwide demand continues to grow for these types of rechargeable batteries, we're going to start running into more depleted supplies of lithium and potentially cobalt. Furthermore, these elements are mined in only a few locations in the world. So we want to sort of ensure that there's a sustainable supply of lithium and cobalt to put in these devices. Furthermore, these batteries don't last forever, and when the batteries are done after maybe 10, 15 years, we don't want those batteries to just end up in a landfill or an incinerator. So for all these reasons, we want to be able to recycle the lithium and the cobalt out of these batteries and put them to beneficial reuse. There are methods to do this already. But the methods that exist currently often use harsh environments, harsh chemicals, and so we're looking for a method that would be environmentally friendly and hopefully cost-effective. Well, it has to be cost-effective to be commercially viable. And so we're interested in using fungi to try to extract the lithium and the cobalt out of batteries when they reach the end of their lifetime. This occurred to us because fungi have been used to extract valuable metals from other solid waste streams, spent refinery catalysts, fly ash, other electronic scrap. So we sort of thought, well, if it works in those applications, it probably ought to work as here as well. So we've been looking at three different fungal strains. We've been testing how they grow, we've been testing what acids they generate when they grow, and we've been testing how well those acids can extract lithium and cobalt from crushed battery cathodes. Generally speaking, it works. We think there's room for improvement. We have a number of things that we're still working on to try to improve the process, but we think that at this point, there's no reason why it doesn't look scientifically viable. We don't know yet how the economics are going to work out, but from a scientific standpoint, fungi work pretty well in terms of producing acids that are able to extract lithium and cobalt out of crushed battery cathodes.